My talk today is devoted to low-dimensional materials. In literature, there are low-dimensional materials, zero-dimensional, one-dimensional, two-dimensional, and here some defining of low-dimensional materials. Carbon is very interesting and unique element which can form not only zero dimensional material like fullerene or one-dimensional nanotubes, but very famous two-dimensional graphite, graphene, and some related materials. Here picture about some outstanding nylon stones in modern material science of low-dimensional system. You can see some very interesting materials of carbon were developed recently. And of course, graphene is more interesting and more fresh materials. And this picture demonstrates dynamics of research applications. You can see very, very intensive research publication in this field. This is very difficult to watch for publication in this system. Now I talk about graphene and some related materials. Graphene has unique physical properties like high mechanical strength, record high thermal conductivity, high mobility of charge carriers, high transparency. This is very good for different application. Some potential field for application you can see on these pictures. In literature, you can find some possible application of graphene and related materials. This is only several example in this field. Of course, more application can be developed in near future. Okay, method for preparation of graphene materials are different. For example, mechanical exfoliation grows on support MOCVD system, organic synthesis, and more interesting for me because I am chemist, chemical exfoliation of compounds containing graphene layers. For example, in our laboratory we developed this chemical exfoliation method, and this method has some advantages which can be used for large-scale production of graphene materials. We have original method for preparation high-exfoliated graphite. For example, from intercalation compounds of this formula, we can use thermal shock method, and after that, more exfoliated graphite is possible repair. Some properties of these materials you can see on this picture. Then, characterization of our materials show in these materials we can find very thin layers, for example, two layers, three layers, and about several layers. But this material has very high specific surface, and we can see from this picture our materials more exfoliated than expanded graphite, for example, from this and this literature or for natural graphite. Dispersion of high exfoliated graphite is very easy, and we can use high polaric organic solvent, and after sonification, ultra sonification treatment in, for example, dimethyl formamide and related polar solvent, we can prepare different solvent with high concentration. For example, our concentration about 18 milligram per liter. For natural graphite, only 4 or near this value concentration. This picture demonstrates electronic spectra, and you can see our material demonstrate more high concentration than natural dispersion from natural graphite. Study of particle size distribution show we have mono model particle size distribution and size about 4-7 microns in the AB plane. Using colloidal dispersion of graphite, we can prepare graphene materials, for example, using filtration on filter or using spray method. You can see from this picture our materials has high transparency and electronic properties. For example, graphene transistor may be prepared by graphene materials have zero band gap, and this is not good for such a device like field effect transistor. For this, it's possible to modify exfoliated graphite why oxygen or chlorine or bromine atom and prepared materials with gap suitable for preparation field effect transistor. Okay. You can see different modified materials using our high exfoliated graphite. Several words about boron nitride, which has related structure. We used the analogous procedure for exfoliation, and we used autoclave procedure and used hydrogen peroxide, and in this procedure we prepared good fine particles too, with diameter about several hundred nanometers. Now about layered halkogenides. First, dihalkogenides. Recently, some literature was shown good properties such materials in field effect transistor, and this especially high mobility of charge carriers about 200 centimeter volt second, and this is beginning for study of lowered halkogenides in our laboratory and other. For example, this picture demonstrates some structure and coordination of metal atom in some polymorph structure of this compound. For example, you can see a metal of 4, 5, and 6 group can form different compounds with lower structure. And we used molybdenum, disulfide, and diselenide in the similar procedure and prefer good colloidal dispersion in different solvents. For example, in this solvent it's possible to prepare colloidal dispersion with very fine particles. Using spray method, it's possible to prepare thin film, and this thin film demonstrates the structure like in bulk material. Raman study of molybdenum dihalkogenide show good structure like bulk material. And molybdenum disulfide is a rather high ohmic transistor, semiconductor, but sometimes is not good properties for application. We used modification of electronic properties of molybdenum disulfide by substitution of ions in cation subletis. You can see the, in this picture molybdenum disulfide high ohmic, and if we use radium for substitution molybdenum in disulfide, we can prepare this characteristic. And finally, niobium give similar properties. This is semiconductor, semiconductor behavior here, metal behavior. This method show we can prepare material with wishful properties which may be useful for different device. Characterization of these materials again show fine particle, but size about several hundred nanometers. This is electronic spectrum. This is power diffraction picture. You can see again high texture in these compounds, which very interesting for thin film. Okay, and now study, recent study, were devoted to trihalogenides of transition metal. Trihalogenides usually described like one-dimensional material, because in these materials we can see chains in direction B, but we can see between one-dimensional change rather strong bonds between metal and halogenide atoms. This is allow us to describe this material like two-dimensional. And we try to use this materials for exfoliation using our method. Of course, if we have molybdenum dihalogenide, the single crystal has a similar habit. But trihalogenide characterized by different shape. It's not possible to use these materials for example, for a mechanical exfoliation. And we use this material for preparation colloidal dispersion. About, again, you can see the data of different method which demonstrate good colloidal properties. This is a sample for thin film. This is demonstrate again powder diffraction, which demonstrate thin film prepared by filtration or spray method give the same results. Okay. This is a characterization thin film by high resolution microscope, electron microscopy, and we can see our layers in this direction, which good correlate with C axis, because we have diffraction peaks in this direction. But maybe more interesting properties, electrical properties on thin films. For example, for niobium 3 chalcogenide, we prepare by spray method and obtain very good mobility of carriers in this thin film. I show this value for molybdenum disulfide about 100-200, but this is more higher than in molybdenum disulfide. This is only first example in our study, but of course in the future we can develop this more interesting materials, I hope. Thank you very much for your attention.
Thank you very much. There are some questions or remarks about. Okay, please.
Could you please indicate the density of carriers in the layers of graphene? The first question. And the second, these layers are highly non-uniform. Are they practical for usage as channels of field effect transistors? Thanks.
About particle. If we use colloidal dispersion by filtration or spray method, particle lay on the surface here. This is high textured material, and this is very very good for different application, because thin film prepared from thin layers. You can see?
But carriers will interact with some particles on the surface of graphene layer. More scattered will be.
Particle lays on surface like this, not similar order, only this.
But it does change the potential, maybe, no?
Yes. This is, I think, usual situation, because lowered particle is not possible to lie like here. Only this. What your first question?
About the concentration of carriers in the layer.
Concentration
of carriers in the layer and the resistivity of the layer.
Concentration of electrons.
Yes.
Mobility, maybe concentration of electrons about 10, 19. I don't know like in English. But the similar in semiconductors.
I have a remarkable question. A remark is a very good car in front of this building. And now a question about accelerated graphite. You said that your laboratory can produce this graphite. So what kinds of defects maybe you observed there? I mean point defects, line defects, if point defects, it's maybe substitution of atoms, impurities or vacancies, or if it is line defects, maybe some steps, due to morphology of substrate or maybe some grain boundaries location.
Okay, you are interested in electronic properties, yes? Our measurement of electronic properties of thin film show the properties depend of contact between particles. If we filter colloidal dispersion for field, the resistivity very high. Then if we use temperature for example 200 centigrade, 300 centigrade, the resistivity more low. It is demonstrate the contact between particle is very important for good resistivity for good conductivity of thin film.
Okay, please.
Thank you for your talk. And a small question: did you do Raman measurement of your graphene sample?
Sorry.
Did you do Raman measurement of your graphene sample?
Raman spectroscopy. What's your question? This is demonstrate the structure, and we use Raman spectroscopy for characterization our sample.
But you didn't present the Raman spectrum of graphene, yes?
Yeah.
You didn't present here.
We use Raman spectroscopy for thin film and for bulk film. The spectroscopy data the same. This is characterized that our thin film is very similar to bulk material.
Okay, the next question, please.
Could you please explain one more question? When you place ohmic contacts to graphene sheet, for example, golden contacts or something else, how do these contacts interfere with electronic properties of graphene sheet? How do they change the band gap or maybe mobility in the point of contact sense?
I want to say about modification of material. If we have, for example, if we have a pure molybdenum disulfide or molybdenum diselenide or other layer of dihalcogenide, we have band gap, for example, 1.8 electron volt or 1.2 electron volt. If we want to change a band gap, we can substitute some molybdenum atoms by atoms with more electrons, for example, molybdenum by rhenium or molybdenum by niobium. In this case, we can tuning the band gap. And this is more usual way for preparation wishful material in electronics.
Okay, thank you very much.